I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes! Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here. Holy shit. This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
You're always blaming everyone else but yourself.
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
That's exactly.
Now what to draw? Definitely, absolutely not a meth lab. Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show. This place is sketchy as hell. An old, abandoned building in the middle of nowhere. Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid. But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? An old lumber car. Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here. That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Is that your bike over there?
Yup.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside. Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Aww, isn't it past yours?
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
A girl like you, with pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan... Look, my boss decides who gets in, all right?
your boss your mom? Follow up. Do you live in your boss's basement?
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on.
This is intense! Shit!
Hey, Delia! Come!
Cute dog. Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and... What's her name?
Delia. She doesn't usually like people.
Yeah. Me neither. Don't mess with Damon. Thanks for the memo.
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I've explained it to you.
How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room? Frank Bowers? What is he doing here? No thanks. I try to avoid hepatitis when I can. Classy.
It's not gonna take any more than an hour to do it.
Is that guy selling merch?
I can't hear you.
Wish I had some cat. That shirt is rad.
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly.
Looks like that parking brake is the only thing keeping that car from rolling down the ramp.
No. Look, we have to...
$20, baby.
$20? That's robbery. And don't call me baby.
Fine. $20, thief.
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I've explained it to you.
Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
Shit! No! Come on!
Thanks for playing, dick. Oh, yeah! Sweet, sweet victory. That's like $200. Holy shit! I'm rich! Yo! Frank!
Hey!
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup, studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
God, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
So, you come here a lot, or...?
Yeah.
Right.
It's cool.
I'm really glad you approve.
I'll see you later.
Whatever.
Drink more, feel less. Yes, please. Sit and spit. $300 dock workers laid off, their pensions canceled? God, Prescott's a real tool. Here we go. Fuck.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope. Don't care, either.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
She returns.
Did you see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
I see you've heard of him. This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
Where do those stairs go?
Up?
Real helpful, Frank. I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine. I'll see you later.
Whatever.
My beer, bitch!
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
Hey, I'm sorry about the beer, okay?
Not good enough.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh,
This is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It
she
won't.
She can take you?
Hey, dickhead. Rachel? Come on! Hurry up!
I'm caught up in the traps of you silhouetting guns. A voice is filled with pain. Lost, no one gave it toss. No one took our slot. So we stole.
Let me go, Frank!
Not gonna happen! Calm down!
Come on, man!
Walk away! Screw this!
Bullshit.
Get the fuck out of here!
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell.
Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right? Daily rituals are important.
Last night, seeing Firewalk live, those skeevy assholes, that girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes.
Terrible news, my fellow Oregonians. Our very own Pacific Steve's famous crab is shutting its doors. Might have something to do with all the health and safety violations they've suffered this year. We've had a near-death experience eating there. Let us know.
I really should get going. Shit, where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's. Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Chloe, breakfast! Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone, too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah. That really makes me want to hurry.
Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out. Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk. Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole.
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah, I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Firewalk? Is that the band you mentioned last week?
I'm still bummed you wouldn't let me go.
Mm-hmm.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that—
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Ever again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such—
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should, too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's— Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do. Here they are. Let's get these to David so he can drive away. No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going. What a piece of crap. The car, too.
do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us. No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination. No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something? Dad's old camera. Do they even make film for these anymore? Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again. This used to hang in the living room. Guess it's ancient history now. Dad's toolbox. He used to get so excited whenever anything sprung a leak or busted. Fifty-fifty chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you. See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
Fine. Whatever. Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I want to talk to you about something.
Fuck!
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Respect him? I think it's time I show this asshole I'm not interested in anything he has to say. What's clear is fuck you.
Language. You are way out of line, young lady.
Language? Here, let me put that in a language you'll understand. Foxtrot. Uniform.
You've got a smart mouth, don't you?
Let me dumb it down for you. I mean, sorry, What has fewer syllables than dumb?
Hey, watch your...
I can crap bigger than you, got it?
Then I hope you're a better plumber than you are a mechanic.
You... Your mother... You're breaking her heart.
At least she has a heart. All you have is... What's it called when you've got one porn stash and zero game?
I was in the army. You will respect me.
You're not my father. You're not even on the same planet as my father.
My job is to make sure you and your mother have a safe and peaceful home.
If your job is to fuck up my life, then someone should give you a raise. And the corner fucking office.
If you were a man,
I'd... It's cool. If you were a man, I wouldn't go so easy on you either.
Don't know why I bother trying.
Mission accomplished.
Country music? Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend. Burning the midnight oil again. What a beautiful day. I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad. I guess Mom left her purse back here. If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn that junk off.
Dad, turn it up.
Picking up my lover from the grocery store.